Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we are inside of Affinity Designer, and I'm going to show you how to put together this kind of artistic abstract text effect that we've got in front of us. So something like this looks really creative with all these different colors in the backgrounds and these drop shadows, as well as this outline going around the entire text. It's almost like a graffiti kind of look, but I've used a standard font for this, and you can use any font that you like, as well as any different shapes and colors that you may want to add inside of this. So if this is something that you would like to learn, then let's get started. So the first thing that you want to do is open up a brand new canvas, and I've done that just up here on the right hand side. Then from here, we are going to grab our artistic text tool over on the left hand toolbar, and we're just going to type out any text that you would like to use. It's entirely up to you. I'm going to stick with the original design that I just showed you and recreate that one. So I'll just go ahead and write unique. Then I'm going to hit Command or Control A on my keyboard to select all of that text, just so I can change the font of this. And we're going to do that in the top left hand corner where we have our font menu. And I'm just going to go in and choose something a little bit better. I'm going to go to my recents list and just go for the same one that I've already used. If you guys want to use the same font as this one, then it is called Dean Condensed. However, like I said, you can use any kind of font that you would like. So what I'm going to do now is just go and grab my move tool, just so I can resize this text by grabbing it from the corner and making that a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to center this in the middle of the canvas by coming up to the top menu bar. Choose the alignment option, and I'm going to align horizontally in the middle as well as vertically in the middle, and just hit apply. Then from here, we are going to go back over to the left hand side, and we're going to grab our pencil tool. Then at this point, it's just a case of getting a little bit messy and creative and just start drawing in our lines all the way through the text. You can use any kinds of shapes or lines that you like. It's entirely up to you. Just make sure you fill that text up. So there is our first stroke created. And what we need to do now is make this thicker and give it a color. So if we come over to the right hand side, and we're going to choose this stroke color right here, and we'll change that from black to being something else. So the first color, I'm going to go for maybe a light blue. Somewhere around there will be fine. Then I'm going to head down to the bottom of this panel, and I'm going to go to the stroke section. If you guys aren't seeing the stroke section here on your right hand side panel, then just make your way up to the top left hand menu bar, go to view, go down to where it says studio, and just make sure that you have that stroke section checked, and you'll have access to that also. Alternatively, if you don't want to use that down here, you still have the same options up here on the left hand side with the stroke color as well as a width. But I generally like to work in the panel down here as we have a few more options available to us. So the first thing we're going to do now is change the width of this to be a lot bigger. And I don't think 100 is going to be big enough for what I'm going for. If you want this to be a little bit bigger, but you've reached your maximum there, it's just a case of double tapping in here and just changing that number to be something else. So I'll go for 150 and make that a little bit bigger. Then I just want to change the ends, which is a cap right here, from being this kind of rounded edge that we got there, just to being flat. So I'm going to select that one right there on the left hand side. This really isn't important because you're not going to see it. It's just my personal preference. And if you find this is too thick for you, honestly, don't worry about it. We can always come back in and change this later on. Everything we're going to create now is going to remain editable all the way throughout the project. So with that one now complete, we're going to go ahead and draw another one. So we'll just start at the top here and just get messy once again all the way through the text. Just like that. We're going to give that one a different color just up here. I'm going to go for a light green, perhaps. Something like that. And at the moment, this does look really messy, but honestly, don't worry about it. Then we'll do the same again. We're going to grab another shape and just start drawing through this text. And we'll give this one a different color. Perhaps maybe a light red. And then finally, we'll just draw one more, which is going to come from the bottom here and just kind of cover some of this text in that area. And that'll do fine. Give that another lighter color. Always looks better with pastel colors, in my opinion, but it's entirely up to you what you'd like to do. So at this point, you're probably looking at this and thinking, what is going on here? This really does not look good. And I completely agree with you, but this is where things are about to change. So first of all, I'm going to go ahead and grab my move tool because we no longer need the pencil tool. And just as a quick note, if you're not entirely happy with any of these shapes that you've created here and you want to go ahead and tweak any of those, then we can do that by coming back over to the left hand side and just selecting our node tool. Once we select the node tool, we're going to have access to all these little white circles, which we are free to grab and just move them around to reshape this however you would like. And we've got these handles here as well, which gives it some extra options. For now, I'm just going to undo this with Command or Control Z and just keep it quick and simple for the tutorial. So moving on with my move tool selected, I'm going to go over now to the layers on the right hand side. And what we need to do is we've got to select all four of these layers together. So if we select the top one and we hold down shift and select the bottom one, that's going to grab everything else that's in between. Then what we're going to do next is insert all of these shapes inside of the text, which is going to act as a mask. So anything outside of this text in terms of all these colors, we're not going to see. And the way we're going to do that is simply by selecting and dragging down. You see, we've got this big blue bar up here. Once you see this big blue bar, just slightly pull it over to your right hand side till it shrinks. Then it'll indent, then just drop it. And now all of these shapes are inside of that text. So straight away, you can see this is looking a little bit more neater than what we just had. So the first thing I want to address is the fact we got this black in the background. That is our original text color. I don't want that there. So if you want to change your original text color, we're going to go up to the text layer, which is that unique one right there. And just up here, we're going to switch back to our black. And I'm going to find something that looks just a little bit better, maybe a darker green, somewhere around that color will be fine. And now this is where we're going to start getting a little bit creative. So what we want to do now is we want to start putting some drop shadows onto these shapes. So if we go down now to our effects, once you've selected one of your layers, and inside of the effects, we're going to choose outer shadow. And all we need to change inside of here is going to be the radius and the offset, possibly the opacity, depending if you want it darker or lighter. But for now, I'm going to give this a radius of maybe 10 and the offset of 10. Hit enter on my keyboard. I think that's looking just a little bit too big, so I'm going to come back in and half that. So I'm going to change that to 5. This is always trial and error. It's just a case of you changing numbers and finding something that you like. So once again, I'm going to hit enter. And that is looking a lot better to me for now. Like I said, you can change this opacity if you want it to be darker or lighter. I'm going to leave that maybe around 60. And for now, I'm happy with that. So what I want to do at this point is copy this effect to every single one of these. And the quick shortcut to do this is to just select the layer itself and hit Command or Control C for copy. Then we need to select the remaining three layers all together. So once again, if you select the top one, hold down shift and select the bottom one, that will grab the one that's in between as well. With all three of these selected and that one's been copied, we're going to go up to the top left hand side to where it says edit. We're going to go down and we're going to paste effect. Then that is going to copy that same effect across all of these. Then we can just simply deselect this with Command or Control D. And we can see kind of what we've got going on here. So it's already starting to look pretty good in my opinion. If you want to start moving around any of these colors on top of each other, you can do that. You've got to simply select and drag and drop on top and it'll start moving things around to whatever it is you're trying to achieve. But me personally, I think I prefer the green underneath the red. Then just to make it a little bit more creative, you don't have to do this if you don't want to, but I'm going to come inside each one of these colors and I'm going to give them a gradient just to make it look that little bit better. So in order to do that, we're going to select our layer that we want to do first. We're going to come up to the top left hand corner where it says stroke. We're going to select that color. We're going to change from color to gradient. Then all we got to do is leave the color as it is on the right hand side, as that's our original yellow that we chose. And we're just going to change the one on the left. And we're just going to come down to where it says color, select that box. And we'll go and give that a darker yellow just so it kind of blends from light to dark. Somewhere around there will be perfectly fine. And it's just a case of doing the same thing across each one of these. Just go ahead and change that to gradient and go back to your left hand side and give that a darker color than you originally had. Somewhere there looks pretty good. And like I said, same thing throughout each one of these. And you may have more shapes than I've got. You can have as many as you like. You can change the sizes. It really is entirely up to you what you want to do with yours. Maybe that's a little bit too dark, so I'm going to bring that lighter slightly. And then finally, I'm going to do that blue. And then we can continue to the next step. So I'm going to make that just a little bit darker on that blue. So with that now finished, we can move on. And honestly, don't worry about anything you've got inside of this in terms of whether you don't like the shape, the size, or the colors. We can edit this all the way to the end, even when you come to save it and finalize it. It's always going to remain editable. And I'll show that just as we approach the end of this. Okay, so the next thing that we need to do is just start bringing all of these different letters closer together and mixing them up. And the way that we would do that is we need to take this from being a font and converting that to a curve. And what that means is it's going to take this font, it's going to create it into its own shape, meaning the text itself will no longer be editable. So make sure that you have chosen your words that you want at this point, as we can't change that later on, but we can of course change all the colors and the shapes inside of that. So in order to convert this to curves, we select this text and we hit the right click button on our mouse, and we're going to go down to where it says convert to curves. So once we select that, we can now see that we have an individual layer for each one of our letters, and they are all inside of this group. So at this point, it's a case now of just moving some of these letters around to where you want them. I'm going to start with this E and kind of work backwards. I'm just going to rotate that just a little bit, maybe like that. I'm just going to drag this slightly over the U. And I'm going to do the same thing with that Q and just rotate that a little bit in that direction, just so we can kind of blend all these together. And the same again with the I in the opposite direction, and just blend that one in with that one. Same with the N, bring that over, and we'll just swing that round the other way. Just bring that up a little bit to separate it. And finally with the U, we're going to bring that over and we'll just rotate that slightly to the right hand side and mix that in there with the N. So if you are happy with what you've got here now in terms of joining all these together, what we need to do is combine all of this into one shape. And the way we'll do that is going back over to the right hand side to our layers. And we're going to select all of these layers like we've done previously. So we're going to start with the E, we're going to hold down shift, and we're going to select the U at the bottom, and that will select everything in between. Then we are going to make our way up to the top menu bar where we have this little menu box right up here, and we are going to select the add option. Once we select that, it's going to combine all of these into one shape. And I'll just deselect that so we can see it a bit more clearly. And at this point, I'm going to make this a lot bigger now so you guys can see it on your screen. So I'm going to come over to the group option. I'm going to select that. And I'm just going to drag this from the corner just to start making this text a lot bigger. And then once again, I'll just come up to the alignment options and I'll center that horizontally and vertically. So the next step is now to put the outline on this, and we'll just do that by selecting once again either the curves itself or the group. In fact, we're going to go ahead and choose the curves as we'll delete the group eventually because we're not going to need it. So with the curves selected, it's now a case of coming back up to the top, and we're going to switch from the fill over to our stroke, and we're going to give that a different color, maybe a darker green. And we'll come back down once again to our stroke section and change that width to be a bit bigger. And this can be any size that you like. I'm probably going to leave that around 15 points. Now we can see this all coming together. So what we need to do next is just put some effects on this. And the way we'll do that once again is select the curves layer itself, come down to the effects menu. And this time round, we're going to go for a 3D. So we'll select that one. We need to then come up to the radius and just change this number from 3 to maybe around 10, just to give it that kind of more 3D beveled effect right there around the edges. Then after we've done that, we're going to come down to the bevel and emboss, and we're going to choose that option. And as default, I think that is on 5 pixels, which looks pretty good the way it is. So I'm not going to change that number. So once you've got what you're happy with, go ahead and hit close. And then we can just deselect that and just see what we've got so far. And I think what we need to do now is just put a gradient on the stroke itself, so it kind of blends in with the rest of it. So if we come back over to the curves layer, and we come over and we make sure that we've got this selected on the color that we are happy with, which I'm quite happy with, a dark green. Then it's a case of coming back over to the left hand side onto our stroke color menu. And we're going to change the color to a gradient. And let's go ahead and change this white to be a darker green or maybe a black. So I'm going to select that green, go for something a bit darker, maybe around there. In fact, that's probably a bit too close to being too dark, so I'm going to go roughly around that color. So right now, this is generally complete, and we could leave it like this if you want to. But what I want to do first of all, before I finish this video, is just show you how we can change and move things around. So first off, I'm going to come back over to the right hand side of layers, and I'm going to take this curves out of this group so we can delete the group because it's no longer needed. So we're going to grab that and just drag that outside of the group. Then we'll just go ahead and delete that group layer. Then you are free to rename this if you like. If you don't want to keep that as curves, you just double tap and name that anything you want to. So inside of this curves now, we have all of our colors that we originally had to start with. And just as I originally stated, we are free to just move these around inside at all times. Throughout the creation process, we can also come back down to the width and we can change the thickness of that, just like I stated. And that is the same across any of these. It's just a case of selecting any other color and changing your width. We could also come down and change the pressure to give it a little bit more of an effect. So if we open up the pressure and we just create maybe a middle point here by tapping, and we just drag down these endpoints, we can see kind of what's going on here. It gets a little bit thinner on one end and gets thicker as it goes along. And you are free to create the same effect across any one of these different shapes. Also, we can change all the colors inside of these if you're not happy with any of them. If I change this color now, it's going to change the entire stroke color. Rather than have the gradient, it's going to replace the gradient. If you just want to go ahead and change the gradient colors, then come back up to your stroke menu on the top left-hand corner. Make sure you are back inside your gradient, and then just select any of the colors that you would like to change, and then just go back in and just simply make that darker or change the color altogether. It's entirely up to you what you want to do with that. I'm just going to Command or Control Z just to undo and go back to my original color. You are also free to come back into the entire curves and change that background stroke color here from green to something else if you like as well. Like I said, it all remains editable apart from the words themselves because we've now converted those to curves. And if you're not happy with the thickness of the stroke around the text, we can come back down to the width and we can make that bigger. Just like that, if you prefer that kind of look. And inside of here, what also might look better if we come down to where we have the align option. And right now we're on this option right here on the left hand side, which is a stroke to the center. If we come over to the right hand side and choose the outside, that's going to possibly look a little bit better than what we had. Maybe that's a little bit too big. Bring that down to around 25. And that might be more for what you're kind of going for. Like I said, all of this is trial and error. It's just a case of trying different things and seeing what you like. We can also make this 3D a lot bigger if you want to. Go back into your effects and just simply change the radius from 10 to maybe something a little bit bigger, around 20. And the same with your bevel and emboss if you want to change that as well. Then all we got to really do to finalize this is just put an image in the background. I'll just go back to the original one that I got and just copy this brick background right there. So Command or Control C. We're going to come back to the one we've just created and Command or Control V to paste. Just going to drop that in all the way at the bottom so the text sits on top of that. And then that is finished. So I hope you found this video useful and you like this effect. If you do, then please give me a thumbs up and give me a comment as it really helps out with the YouTube algorithm and helps other people find my content. And of course, if you haven't already, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button and check out all of my other tutorials I have available as well as any future releases I have coming. If you are brand new to Affinity Designer, then I do have an Affinity Designer crash course available on my YouTube that will teach you all the basics from getting started to creating your very first project and will give you a great understanding how the software works. And I will go ahead and link that in the top right hand corner now if you wish to check that out. I've also created crash courses on Affinity Photo and Affinity Publisher if you want to check those out also. But for now, I hope you have a great day and I will see you in my next video.